Rosh Hashanah is one of my favorite days of the whole year. It's a holiday on the Jewish calendar that begins usually around the fall months, where you blow shofar, this ram's horn, and you make a sound punctuating the year, saying, we're going to begin again. And it is full of traditions and full of family, meals and spending time together in community. Rosh Hashanah really stands out in the Jewish calendar as a uniquely, not exclusively Jewish holiday. This is a moment where Jews and non-Jews can really come together. It's an invitation to come together as community way beyond any one of our tribes. Rosh Hashanah is actually a two-day holiday, and I take from that that I have so much to celebrate and actually so much to let go of from the year that just ended that it takes some time. The most common way that people observe Rosh Hashanah doesn't happen in the synagogue, it happens at home. And the meal right before the holiday begins is the gathering of friends and family, and there are various traditions, including taking pieces of an apple and dipping it in honey and saying, may the year be sweet like this. I remember as a young child, I'm actually allergic to apples, and so the tradition of dipping an apple into honey was one that I just couldn't do. And so eventually we started finding a new fruit, a fruit we'd never tried before. And so it was always exciting to find, what does the fruit look like? How do I prepare it? Does it taste good in the end at all? I remember as a child just feeling so excited about it every year. As a parent now, I really hope that my children are experiencing it not as an allergic reaction, but as an exploration, as something to discover. Even though it's an ancient tradition, it's never the same when you do it right. The greeting for Rosh Hashanah, if you see someone who's in that zone, is you say, Shana Tova, may it be a good year. The extended version of that is L'shana Tova Tikatevu V'techatemu. May you be written and inscribed for a good year, because one of the metaphors on Rosh Hashanah is that God has a book of life. And my biggest prayer for everybody, especially me, I guess, is that I be written in for one more year of life. And so my wish for you when I see you is that you have that blessing too. In the spirit of Rosh Hashanah, what I really wish everyone, both physically present and virtually here, a sense of safety in the world, a sense of health and peace, and that the people that you love and the people you don't know and the people you disagree with can actually experience a world where there's less tumult, where we can actually stand together, hopeful about the year to come. So I wish that for you.